Hundreds of people forced to march 60 miles with no food or water.
The event more than 60 years ago went down in history as the Bataan Death March. New this morning, Action 7 News reporter Dominic Garcia shows us how people are working together now to honor those who died.
It's kind of hard, you know, to think about what's gone.
Ida Mae Ames lost her husband, Virgil, just 3 weeks ago.
It's been real hard for me, yeah.
But what's left as a reminder of him is that of a hero.
He was very proud to do what he did.
He served in the Philippines during World War II, holding off the Japanese in Bataan until they were forced to surrender. What happened next was horrific.
It was really gruesome.
Thousands of those captured were forced to march for days.
They wouldn't let them have anything to eat or drink.
And many died before what would be known as the Bataan Death March was over.
On each side of the road as you go by, you could see all the dead.
60 years later, the memories of what her husband went through still weigh on her, and she wishes more people knew about the price the soldiers paid.
They deserve all the credit they can get.
So do many others.
No other group has ever encountered that sort of thing, and yet no recognition has ever been given to them.
After years of trying, a bill is now being considered that would give the Congressional Gold Medal to Bataan Death March veterans.
They did what their service asked them to do, and they suffered for it, but no award has ever been given to them, and it's just about time.
It's been a slow process, and they still have a ways to go, but many are hoping, and although her husband didn't live to see it,
it would have been real nice.
Ida Mae says a medal like that would have a special place with all the others.
I'd managed to get it in there.
Dominic Garcia, KOAT Action 7 News, live this morning.
The bill was submitted by Congressman Tom Udall earlier this month, and if it passes, one congressional gold medal will be presented to the veterans from the Bataan Death March. Right now, officials are gathering sponsors for the bill and are hoping it passes before the end of the year.